so today, a very unmotivated day. I didn't video anything today. Just a lot of little things got done. RJ and I really didn't have a whole lot of motivation. I guess the big thing that tugs on my heart is that we lost Gonzo last night. He went to sleep and just never woke up, which we knew was coming. Unfortunately, when you know your animals, you kind of can see it coming. You just see them getting older. You see them not getting around very well. You see them not being that young, spry thing. And we couldn't find anything wrong with him. And Doc just kind of warned us that it probably was coming to the end. Gonzo was one of the first goats that we ever got. So, I think RJ was 13, so he was probably right at 7 or 8. He wasn't a baby when we got him. So, I don't know how old he was when we got him. 6 months to a year or so. I don't know, he might have been 2. I don't really know for sure, but, so he was 7, 8, 9 at the, not, probably 9 at the most, and probably 7 at least, I don't know. So, a little tough to take, but, he was one of my favorites too, so that doesn't help. But we had craft day, not a whole lot of participation there today because, first off, it's the Tuesday after Thanksgiving. Some of the homeschoolers are just getting back into routine. Regular schoolers going back to school just didn't have a whole lot of participation, which we kind of saw that coming. That's okay though. So I have a plan for a summer, like children's guild. So, we're working on that. Made an appointment with a CPA today. Apparently I have like, I don't know how many certificates for the stuff that we do through the state of Oklahoma. If I want to sell meat, I have to have a license. And for the egg sales, I have to have a license. And for everything, anyway, I got a call from the IRS saying that they thought I missed one. So I'm going to a CPA. I'm just going to take it all to a CPA. He's going to have to advise me on what we probably need, how we need to handle it, and where that line is between business taxes and licenses and farm taxes and licenses. So I don't know. I'll figure it out. I have that appointment next week. So, we'll see how far that goes. We'll see what we have to do and how confusing it's going to be, but we got this. It just, the whole day was like that. Just little things that you don't want to deal with. I did get the Christmas tree up in the barn, and if you remember in one of the other videos, I found this amazing, these 5 amazing lights for like $1.52 at Lowe's, and I bought all 5, and I finally got them up in the barn tonight, and I went out there, and it is amazing how much light they provide. I couldn't believe it. So I'd given $1.52 for each of the lights, and I have 5 of them, so we're talking $7.50, maybe $8, less than $10, and that thing is now lit up. The whole walkway, the alleyway, you can saddle and unsaddle in there without tripping over anything. It's amazing. So that's up. The Christmas tree is up. I still have 1 more Christmas tree to go, which is the one out front. Sorry, it's been long nights, and just last night I slept really hard. But I got up feeling like I hadn't slept at all. I don't know what the deal is. But anyway, I got the trees up. A little of this, a little of that. It's really been a gloomy day. Like, with the sun and everything, there's been no sun. It's just really, really overcast. You could smell air. the air, you know, you can smell like the rain and that dirt taste, so in the air outside. I don't know how to explain it, but and then I just kind of puttered, did dishes, cleaned up the house. Other than that, nothing. I didn't even video any of the stuff that I did today. So, I mean, I popped a few pictures. RJ using food vlog. He's like, yeah, that's fine. But I didn't video anything because I really didn't work on anything. Ice is out in the new stall. Derp is out there. There are things I need to be getting done. I've got some feeders I've got to build. I've got this amazing plan for a hay manger out there in the new barn, and it's an old-fashioned hay manger with a new-fashioned twist. We have the old barn out here that we don't give tours to. We have a video, and if I can think, I will try to put it in the video, in this video. I'm not sure how to do that, but I will try and figure out how to put one of those little things and point to it. Yeah, right. No. I would try to put it in the link below in the description or something. But we have an old barn. And when I say old, I mean like 1910, 1920s. All built out of wood. In it is a spot for two horses. Ooh. And remember, the horses used to just be in there to eat at night, and then they were turned loose in the day. And then they worked. You know, they didn't really work turned loose, but they worked, they plowed the field, whatever. In that old barn is an A-frame divider and a big, deep manger with feed boxes in the corner. Like, it's a square made out of wood that, you know, they dump the feed in. So they'd have the feed in one side, and then the rest of this would be all the way down deep to the ground, at kind of a V coming off the wall, and you put the hay in there. Well, I like the look of the old mangers. I don't like the way they're built because you can't clean them out, and if the horse doesn't eat all the way down to the bottom, or it gets the hay gets wet, it gets moldy. So I've come up with a design in my head that I'm still trying to figure out. But pretty much, I'm going to make the bottom, make it appear to be, and make it kind of a little bit boxier. But then it's going to have a pull-out bottom so that everything will drop to the ground, put that bottom back in, and then you just rake out the old hay from underneath so that it's got a good way to clean it out. So, but I've got it in my mind. I can't get it on a piece of paper, and then I've got to figure out dimensions and all this lovely stuff, but I'm working on it. I'll get there. And I think I have the stuff I need to build it. I have some leftover wood from the actual stalls. I've got some scraps for the feed box part. Yeah, I'm going to get in there tomorrow, I'm hoping, if it doesn't rain. I have two things that I need to get done, and that the first one is that manger and the feed boxes, because right now we're tying buckets to the stalls. Actually, three things I need to get done. I need to get that done. I need to get the stall walls secured to the things. RJ hasn't made the little brackets for them yet, so we're just going to secure it with wire, which I just haven't done yet. And then, sorry. Then I need to burn everything that's on the north fence line. I need to burn it all out, and we're going to put a living fence in there. So I have borrowed a torch. We're waiting on, unfortunately, we have a red fire days until it rains, and it's supposed to rain tomorrow. So I've got the torch, and if we do that, I will definitely videotape that. You won't see me just sitting here talking. We'll be like, we're doing this. But we're waiting on it to rain before we burn all that out. There's a bunch of trees in there and just grass and stuff that's grown up. And it's not been cleaned out since we lived here or his parents. It's just low on the totem pole kind of chore. So, yeah, that'll get done hopefully tomorrow if it rains. So, waiting on the rain. And then you get to see fire. So, anyway. So, those things I need to get on, and I'll get on them probably tomorrow. I have to. But I do have to get some measurements and some designs. I have it in my head. I just have a hard time getting it from head to paper to the thing. So, if you remember, I started the inside of that barn. It took me a while, but once I got it, figured out my concept, and I'm going. Same thing with the stalls that are out there. We're kind of out of money on that right now because it takes $100 at a time. You know, is how we're doing it. And you see a lot of progress when I get down to the last $100 where it's just the pickets, because once that's done, then it's like, oh yeah, that stall's good to use. So, yeah, we will see. But, anyway, I've got to get the mangers done, and like I said, I have it in my head. I just can't get it to paper yet, but it'll get there. I'm super excited about it because it's like, oh, I could do this. So, yeah, I could if I just figure out how. But anyway, so, all right, I think I'm going to get off of here. I do have those things to get done tomorrow. Some of which I probably should have gotten done today, but it's just a bad day. Just and not really bad, it just weighs heavy on your heart. Just kind of sets the tone for a blah day, you know? So, anyway, I'm going to wrap this up. I will talk to you guys next time, and hope to see you tomorrow.